Hello everyone, once again welcome to my YouTube channel IELTS Platform. As promised to you last time, I am here again with my speaking session. I told you that I will be sharing some videos related to writing and some related to speaking. Although you can always ask me your doubts regarding to listening and reading by posting them in the comments or in my email ID that I have provided to you. But I'll be sharing videos related to writing and speaking. So we are going to have a speaking session today. We are going to have a cue card discussion today. So let us see what a cue card is. A cue card is a topic given to you in the exam wherein you have 1 minute time to prepare and you have to speak on the topic for 1 minute or 2 minutes. We try that we prepare ourselves for speaking for 2 minutes so that in the examination hall we are able to speak for 2 minutes. So let us see what topic we are going to share or discuss today. So let us see. The topic is, describe a time you borrowed something from your family or friend. As you can see here, the topic is, describe a time you borrowed something from your family or friend. So I hope all of you are clear with the meaning of borrowed. If any of you is not clear with the meaning of borrowed, the meaning of the word is, when we buy something, we go to market, we pay the price and we get it. So there, the process is of buying. There is exchange of money. There is a price that is paid for the product or the thing that we get. But when we are borrowing anything from anybody, we are not paying the price for that. We just either appreciate them or we praise them for their help to us, but we are not paying them the price. We just take them for returning it to them and not for keeping it with ourselves. It is for a short period of time. So let us see what are the hints or cues related to this topic. The very first hint or the very first cue is, what you borrowed means what was the thing that you borrowed. The next hint or the next cue is, who you borrowed it from means who was the person, whether it was a family member or it was a friend from whom you borrowed this product. The next cue or the next hint is, what you borrowed it for means what was the purpose, what was the reason that made you borrow this product from your family member or your friend. Next and the last cue or the hint is, and explain why it was useful to you means how it helped you, how the product came into your use. So before we start with speaking about the topic, before discussing the topic, let us see how we prepare the topic. So as I also told you in my last video that you get a paper and a pen or a pencil from the examiner to write down your hints. Some of the students, some of you may prefer to just think over in your mind in that 1 minute time to prepare for the topic. That is very well, that is very fine. Of course, you must think about the topic for a minute, if not for a minute, for 15 seconds, 30 seconds, 10 seconds. However, how much time you want, you can think, but not, of course, more than a minute. And they will tell you when you can start. So you need not worry that my 1 minute is running out. Have I thought for more than 1 minute? There is nothing like that, right? But if there are some people who want to pen down the points. So how can we pen down the points? How can we use that pen and the paper that they have provided to us? So let us see. Here you can see very clearly how I have written all the points, how I have jotted down all the points. So in the center I have written IELTS cue card topic. That is just for reference. You need not write this. You can simply write time you borrowed. Just a hint. If you do not want to write, do not write this. Just make out a circle, right? Now let us see what points we can write. There were 4 pointers given to you. These are the hints or cues to prepare for the topic. Otherwise also we can write down some points. For example, try to quote some quotation if that comes to your mind. For example, they were talking about a time you borrowed something from your family or friend. So I thought that I would speak on friend. So a quotation, like very well known quotation, a friend in need is a friend indeed. I did not write the full quotation. Why? Because I need to speak it. I need not write. So I just wrote in 3 to 4 words a friend in need, right? Now let us see what is the next point that we can make. So they asked what you borrowed it for, right? Occasion. And I have already mentioned what you borrowed. I have not yet mentioned, but I have mentioned from whom I borrowed, somewhere, right? So what I borrowed, the occasion was the wedding of my cousin. The topic which I am going to speak is the product that I have borrowed is my cousin's wedding. So next, I have just made a point, lot of shopping. Next point I have made is no ideal dress for cocktail party. So means somewhere you can think that what I borrowed was some piece of clothing, right? Now let us move on to the next point that I have written. Your points can be totally different from mine. These are just pointers or hinters to help you prepare with the topic. So the next point is borrowed friend's dress. So what was the product? What was the thing? As they mentioned in the very first point, what you borrowed. So what I borrowed? Borrowed friend's dress, right? Now let us move on to the next point. That is, it was a beautiful dress in olive green color. I have mentioned the color, and I have mentioned that it was a beautiful dress. Of course, when you are borrowing something from someone, why you are borrowing? Because you don't have that thing and you found that thing attractive. So of course it is very important to mention that it was a beautiful dress or a beautiful thing or a thing of your use, right? Now let us come on to the next point. That is, it fitted well. Of course, your borrowing dress, if it is ill fitted, if it doesn't fit well, either it is too tight or it is too loose, it won't look good. So I have mentioned this point, it fitted well. And if I am borrowing something from someone, if it is beautiful, we are bound to get lots of compliments. So that is what I wrote, lots of compliments. And the last hint, of course, when we are taking something from someone, we are going to return it because they borrowed it. So when I am returning it, what will I do? I will thank my friend, right? So these are the hints. If you want to make them in a circle form of thing, you can write them like this, or you can simply write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pointers. Okay, it is not necessary to write like this. It is just a way. You can choose any way. You can think in your mind. You can use this circle form, or you can simply jot down 1, 2, 3, 4 points. It is up to you how you want to prepare in that 1 minute of time. So let us see how we are going to speak. And now I am going to start with the topic. Thank you for the cue card. It is very well said that a friend in need is a friend indeed. And it so happened true with me too. It was the occasion of my cousin's wedding, and I had done a lot of shopping for different wedding functions. As in India, we have a lot of traditions and customs related to weddings. So I have a very special bonding. I have a very special connection with this cousin of mine. And I was really excited for this wedding, as it was the last wedding of our family. And all of us were really looking forward to it, especially me, because we have been really good friends ever since our childhood. I share everything with this cousin of mine, and that is why her wedding was the most special occasion for me, and I wanted to look my best in her wedding. So for her wedding, I had done a lot of shopping. I had bought a lot of dresses. There was an occasion of cocktail party in her wedding, and I couldn't find a suitable dress for the occasion. I searched a number of shops. I went to a number of designers, but there was nothing that could please my eyes, that could fit me well, and which made me look beautiful and which was appropriate for the occasion. So I was really worried as what would I wear on this occasion. I searched for the dress in my wardrobe also, but I couldn't find a suitable thing. So while I was thinking about what I could wear or where I could get the dress from, I was just reminded of one of my close friends. Her name is Priya, and I was reminded that she is having a very beautiful dress in olive green color. I immediately called her and asked her about her availability at home. Fortunately, she was available and I went to her place immediately. I asked for her dress and she was so happy to share their dress with me. Fortunately, both of us have almost similar sizes, and when I tried her dress, it fitted me so well. She told that dress was looking really pretty on me and it was enhancing my beauty. So on the occasion of my cousin's cocktail party, I wore the dress. The dress actually looked really pretty on me. I looked so beautiful wearing that dress. I got lots and lots of compliments wearing the dress. I had never got so many compliments ever, though I had got ready on a number of occasions, but this particular dress made me fetch so many compliments from all my family members as well as many people who had come to attend her cocktail party. Finally, I came back from the wedding and I returned the dress to my friend. I thanked her and shared all the compliments that I received on her on my cousin's wedding because of her dress. So that was the time that I shared something from someone, and it turned to be really fruitful for me as it saved my money and it made me look beautiful. Besides, it also fetched me a lot of compliments. Thank you.